America is opening up, and most signs finally point to a recovery, but not so fast. Economists say that you should also brace yourself for sticker shock on many items that you probably use every day. National Desk's Angela Brown is looking into what is behind this increase. I have noticed it's getting more expensive now, even just to go to the grocery store, right?
Yes, we're talking things like fruit and vegetables across the board. Well, there's a combination of factors driving up prices, the cost of raw materials, and more people vaccinated and ready to basically go out. And you may have already seen this price hike, at least if you pulled up to the gas station and tried to pump some gas. A new report says that gas prices jumped by 9% in March, and more price hikes are coming.
The Vargas family has plenty to smile about. Their loving family is growing.
I'm really excited. I was like shaking when I found out that I was pregnant.
With a new baby boy in the mix comes a stinky problem.
You really do go through so many diapers, and it's kind of crazy.
Jackie is firmly Team Pampers, but now she's worried she's going to have to pay more. P&G, the maker of Pampers, said starting in September, it will charge some retailers like Walmart and Costco roughly 5 to 9% more to offset the rising cost of raw materials. Stores can then decide whether to pass that cost to consumers.
From the perspective of the companies, like, well, we think we're going to lose some money because we have to make more, or like the materials are going to cost more, so we're not going to lose that money. We're just going to start hiking prices. And I was like, really?
But it's not just diapers. The April report from the Bureau of Labor Statistics found that the price of fruits and vegetables rose nearly 2% since February. Gas prices increased by 9.1% in March. Kiplinger, a business forecasting publisher, says gas prices have stabilized for now, but could hit an average of $3 a gallon by spring. Dr. Jeff Guernsey from Cedarville University says supply chain issues and the pandemic are playing a role.
Quite simply, it is what we say, supply and demand. Demand for many products is now beginning to increase as we're coming out of some of the worst parts about COVID. And, you know, the unemployment rate is down. People are able to get back to work. People maybe feel safe traveling a little bit more.
But price increases for some of your favorite products has parents like expectant mom Jackie Vargas bargain shopping to reduce costs.
Every time we go to the store, I try to make sure I have a coupon. If I'm going to buy diapers. Oh, you want to say hi?
She's so cute. I had to add that in.
Oh my gosh, she's adorable. I love that.
Well, get this. If you're going to buy a car, you may end up paying more. The average price for a new car was just over right here, $37,000. J.D. Power says that's up over 8% from the same period a year ago.
So we know the prices are going up. Is there any indication, Angela, when they could come back down?
Well, experts are saying that they expect the price increase to last only a few months. These price hikes are coming at a time, really, when businesses are opening back up while trying to meet the demand of all these new customers and supply networks are stretched thin. Experts expect these issues to get resolved as the pandemic eases.
All right, let's hope so. Thank you, Angela.